It started with a strange phone call from Jared Mitchell, who was the head of the election unit at that time. And he approached me and asked, can you go to Albania? We will have a team around you. And it ended up with me as an on-site coordinator, the one-person core team, so to say, and together with me, two LTOs in Tirana. We started to meet people from election commission, the courts, political parties, and for every single person it was something very new. And it was a new approach. We had no office. We used my hotel room, and we had a very fancy printer, the old ones, you feed it one paper at a time. Mm-hmm. We were hiring cars, hiring people for translation, and so on and so forth. And we started to report to Warsaw. We had around 40 short-term observers coming for election day. I think we briefed the observers pretty well. We had problems with accreditation. They were not used to the systems. The message from the mission was quite damaging. And when we talked to Warsaw, is it possible for us to issue the statement? And they say, well, go ahead. A two-person team or a one-person team can't actually handle everything. I mean, now operations, all the experts, our analysts in the team makes, it's really, really professional. And, cover all parts and stages of the process, which was probably not possible in 1986. We started with LTOs, a couple, and then the following year we had some more. And then we realized that, okay, we can't handle the small core team can't handle the LTOs. Then we found out, we appoint an LTO coordinator. Step by step, it was a growing industry, more and more.